Assalamu alaikum everyone. I hope all of you are doing fine and having a good time in your vacation days. Gretchen, well, you know that we were discussing chapter number 7 the days we left, and we were on the world problems of this chapter. So I'm going to continue from where we left. But before that, I want you people to just revise the concept of average. And I've made you written the formula as well. And the formula is sum of values over total values. Okay, you can write it somewhere else as well still. But I hope that you have already written this formula. Okay, now before coming to the lecture, I would like you people to just open the page number 32 of your books and go through the question number 4 statement. You can pause the video here as well. So I expect you have gone through it. Basically, what is asked in the question is that you have to calculate the amount of juice that every student gets, every children gets. Okay, so you have to just clearly understand that in the word problem, the most important thing is to recognize the data. Solution is not very difficult in this question. The main theme is the data. Because sometimes the value given to you may be the sum of values, sometimes the total number of values, and sometimes the average itself may be given, and you may be asked to calculate the sum or total number of values. Okay, so you have to have a very close observation of the data, that what the quantities given to us are representing what. For example, in this case, it is given that there are 5 children. So it means the total number of children is 5. So this formula of average, where 3 values are there, average, total values, and sum of values, this 5 will be substituted in place of total number of values. And similarly, you have been given the total amount of juice. You know, the sum of the value is 6.75 liters. Okay. So what he has asked us to calculate is the juice each student gets. So I have applied the formula. And juice each student gets is actually the average amount of quantity that every children is having. Okay, so you can simply substitute the values in the formula. 6.75 divided by 5. What is 6.75? Is the sum of values, and what is 5? The total number of values. Okay, you may be confused that which value should be used as a sum and which value should be used as a total. I've made you an example with this, that whatever you want to calculate should be in the numerator, and with respect to what you want to calculate should be in the denominator. What it means, you want to calculate the amount of juice that each student get, means you are restricting the student as children as one, and you want to yourself evaluate the value amount of the juice that he is drinking or getting. So it means that the variable quantity is juice, not the number of children. So that's why the unknown, the finding value should be in the numerator, and this will be considered as sum, and the remaining will be considered the denominator or total. Because in other words, total and sum are the same thing, but this must be kept in mind. And you can divide it as I done in the right block of the page. You can see the divider, and it's coming out to be 1.35. And what I've seen in your previous notebooks as well, that you people are not showing your calculations, especially of the multiplication and deviance. Even addition and subtraction calculations are required. Whenever the two or more decimal places work is there, or the number of digits are actually in sufficient number, you have to show your calculation, okay? Because you are not allowed to just simply press the calculator button and calculate the answer, okay? So you have to show me your calculations as well. So this is exactly what we have been with this topic. Now, you have to evaluate page number 33 and 32, the remaining 3 questions, question number 3, 5, and 6. By yourself, and if there is any query, you can surely ask for. Thank you very much.